early season. It's a beautiful day out. So I'm just going to hit a few spots. I'm going to hit top to mid-water. I started with this here Rapala, Rapala, I like to call them. It's a surface top water swimmer, almost like an SP minnow. But I'm going to work the top, hit some spots, and then work the bottom with some jigs later. Where I have a hunch it might do better with the jigs deeper. So just trying to do a melee of spots and see what happens. I have a hunch that nothing going on. I don't see too much life. So I'm assuming the fish are holding deeper. But I wouldn't doubt if I came back here tonight, I'm going to try a deeper hole. And I wouldn't doubt if I came back here tonight that some fish will move in. It's extremely warm today. The water still feels below 50. So I'm going to try another spot here and just share with you a real pretty sight. Always like to look at that there. A great place to catch a sunset. Well, we got a little bit deeper water here, so I'm going to probably throw some lighter jigs out. So I'm going to switch up. I'm going to throw the spinner a little and switch things up. There's no weeds, but soon this place will just be inundated with weeds. Just going to take a coffee break here, and then I'm going to take a decent walk. It's fish are definitely in their winter mode today. Like I said, there's not much activity. I don't see the weeds didn't start popping up. There's no I don't see any crawdaddies, no sore bellies, no minnows. Nothing to get a chase in any baits. So I'm just taking it easy, enjoying the day, and I'm gonna take a walk over the hill. I like fishing all over here, so but I'm gonna check this one spot out. I know a lot of people, it's the fish tend to bed in there a little earlier. I don't know if they're there, but we're gonna take a look. Days like today, you're probably best with bait, an old-fashioned bobber, and because the fish are really slow if they are around, and I'm banking there in the deeper channel still. They might come in and out at certain periods, so I would never know. We still got some sunlight, and let's see what happens. Knew they'd be hanging in there. These guys are very toothy. Pretty fish. Maybe he'll get off. Oh, I think that was. You don't have to touch him. Don't touch him. He did get off, but. I And that's what I got him on. It's a wee craw. And it's an old one. You can see I lost my treble on the back. I have to epoxy a hole on there. Alright, I'm glad I could share that moment with you. It's an early season. And I came back here and brought it back up. All you need really is that middle hook, but fishing's, you know, early slow season. But I came back here. I was fishing in a cooler part of the lake here, and I found a lot of weeds growing. Those weeds actually will create heat, so puts fish on the feed. Now the pickerel, it's a little cool. They have a lower temperature tolerance than a lot of other freshwater fish. Crappie might get a bass to hit, but I'll take them all day. That was thrilling. Let's get back out there. But that's what he took. I like the darker color. You see we're in the shade. And there's rocks here along the edge of the weed line that they're relating to both. There's a lot of structure in there. You can see the weeds already coming up. And that tree could be holding. All I was doing, this floats, it's basically just a crankbait. Think of like one of those stupid face poppers or a big metal lip. But just, I give it little sharp jerks so you can feel the vibration. And maybe a little pause. Just like that. And I change the retrieve. I mean, I'll bring it in slow, fast, and whatnot. Maybe I'll try a bigger one in a little bit.
Not over yet.
Oh yeah.
You're a little bigger than I think the other one. What do we got? Oh, he's a big mouth.
Largemouth bass.
That's a pretty sight. He's hungry too. You can tell he's got the winner. Skinnies. Let me get my pliers. He hit that real good too.
You'd almost use the water like a table sometimes. Show you, this is one of my favorite lures in the whole wide world. This is the original Finnish Swedish minnow. This is a Rapala, some if you may. This is a size 11. They come in all different sizes. I started with a smaller one and put the bigger one on. Now it's gold, silver, whatever colors. I like gold and silver. Go a little overcast, stained water, silver, bright sunny days, and
really good stuff. I've been fishing with these for a long, long, long time. I probably did more fishing with these than any other minnow. And they're very light. This isn't even a quarter of an ounce, I don't think. And they're durable, too. They'll take a lot of fish. Okay, we got another one. This one, I think, is a pickerel. No, it's... another bass. What I do is I tie them, that's a loop knot. It gives it a little more wiggle. I don't know if you can see that knot there. It gives the Rapala a little bit more wiggle. That's good to do with your SP minnows, but you're using a swivel most of the time anyway. Here, this is very light. I think this is 4 pound test I'm using. Let's see if we get a few more before the night's in. It's getting late now.
Let me show you how
working the Rapala. Actually, there's two ways. I like to just twitch the rod. If there's a top water bite, I'll let it sit there. But just like that, those little twitches, pause. And actually, if you're looking for pickerel, a slow, steady, straight retrieve. And I've seen from fishing with buddies of mine in the past that I generally have an erratic action when I'm working the Rapala minnow. I've seen people, they generally, when they start fishing, they'll just reel it in just as such, which is perfectly fine. And I have found that you will hit more pickerel with a straight, steady retrieve. And if you're looking for bass, more of an erratic attack, because they hit it all different angles. The pickerel will shoot straight out and nab it. A bass will kind of curve and cut and then hit it, you know, when it's jerking. So the pickerels will miss it if it's moving in this erratic way. So they might be going after it, but they're shooting past it. But a steady, straight retrieve, the pickerel will actually have a better chance of hitting your lure. But I'm, you know, changing up my retrieves and doing different things. So that's generally how I'm fishing this.
We got a trout.
It looks like it's a brown, a trout. It's really neat. Right, we should stop these in here. It's really neat. I didn't expect that. I know they're here, but something else I really start. Oh. That's a big mouth. That was a quick, furious bite. I was Gina Jasmine came back here, I had my best chance at sunset. I missed a big one. That's how it works. But I picked up a trout, another nice bass. I think they might be used to this lure working for some reason. But I might try something else. And now I finally might go home. One or the other. But thanks for watching.